Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at Cameron MCNZ on Twitter, and I want to teach you how to block user input when you're running your UiPath robots alongside a user who might be sitting at the local workstation or terminal. Here's a neat little robot, the best little robot you're ever gonna see. I've got it deployed to UiPath Assistant, although you can see UiPath Studio in the background. And when it's run, it's best run picture in picture. So if I run this in picture, you'll see the picture in picture window start over there, try and log me in. And the idea of this robotic process is if I drop a file in this downloads folder and watch this happen, boom. All of a sudden, the robotic process will process the Excel file, log into rpacertified.com, a good site to check out, and then start registering users based on the Excel file. Now, there's a problem here. As cool as picture in picture is, notice the fact that I can still interact with this user interface. So if I start typing stuff in here, you know, I can really mess up the input of data, because nothing's blocking input here. Nothing's stopping me from typing things in. And you can see that's a valid user, but in fact, the registration has failed. So that is no good. So how can you change that? Well, I'm going to stop this automation. Oh, where is UiPath Assistant? There it is right there. Let's give that a little bit of a stop. Okay, close that picture in picture window. And there we go, that's done. Now over here in UiPath Studio, I've got my project. That's all the code for it. It's a lot of code there, too much for me to talk about right now, but trust me, that's it. Now there's this cool activity called block user input. I'll type block over here. You'll see it over here. And I'm gonna drag that to the top of the sequence. And I'm not just gonna drag it to the top of the sequence, but I'm actually gonna drag all of the content of the robot, everything the robot did, into it. So now everything that runs is running in this block user input mode. Notice there's an escape key, Alt F10. If I do that, well, in that case, I can break out of the block input facility here. But I'm going to click Control S there and publish that to my UiPath Assistant. So now look at what happens when I run this in picture in picture. I say start in picture. Click yes, even though I wasn't designed originally to be in picture, that's going to change the name of this file slightly so there's not a conflict here. I'm going to copy that, go back to the downloads folder, paste it in here, and let's watch this process take off. All of a sudden, it's going to read this Excel file. It's going to start typing things in. But look what happens if I try and go and actually click on the page. I'm trying to click on the page. I'm trying to mess up the workflow, but I can't. And the reason that I can't mess up the workflow here is because I've got that block user input facility enabled. And there you go. That's the key. Don't just run your things picture in picture, but add that block user input, and then the user sitting in front of the terminal can't mess things up. And there you go. That's how easy it is to block user input when you're running your UiPath robots alongside a user. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com? I'm the editor-in-chief over there. I've got lots of great tutorials on UiPath and robots and RPA, you name it. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can always follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and do the subscribe thing on that YouTube channel.